And then those temperatures will stay above average on Monday. What can I get out there? Oh, it's going to do another one, but I'll tell you more tomorrow.
All right, Casey, thank you.
All right, later this week, NASA will make a fourth attempt for a pre-launch test of its Artemis I Mega Moon rocket.
A local company is part of that mission. KTLA 5's Gayle Anderson has more from Canoga Park.
We are on the property here in Canoga Park, and what you are looking at is what I would describe as the kind of thing you might see, a space version, the kind of thing you might see at the Sawdust Festival, a giant kiln with product that is fired in this. But this is a bit more sophisticated. We're here with Helen Lewin of the RS-25 flight support engineer with this project going to the moon. Helen, I've never seen anything, a kiln this large. Am I calling it the right thing, a kiln?
Yes, essentially that's what it is. We also call it an oven sometimes. It's where the nozzle is constructed, and we have 1,080 tubes, and it's covered with a jacket. And so this kiln is where they bake those pieces to make them all glue together.
Now inside there is what we would call, I would call an engine, but you call it a nozzle.
The nozzle is the most conspicuous part of the engine. It's the part that you see on the bottom when they're testing the engine.
Oh, let us show them what you mean. Here's a little test footage, because testing is happening even as we speak at the Kennedy Space Center. Okay, so go ahead, tell me about this now.
So the full engine has the power head on top and the nozzle on the bottom. And we've got four of these on the Artemis I vehicle, and that's the vehicle that's going to be going to the moon. We haven't been to the moon for 50 years, so this is really exciting. And it will be orbiting the Earth, and then it'll go to the moon, orbit the moon, and then come and land off the coast of California.
And then again, to make sure people know you're not making this up, here's the animation. I don't believe you, Ellen. Here's the animation showing you how it's going to leave the Kennedy Space Center, circle the Earth, and then whip around toward the moon, and then circle the moon. It's not going to land. This first mission will not land on the moon.
That's right. It's just going to do an orbit, and it's not manned. We don't have astronauts yet. But we're taking steps to get there, because we want to go back and have a permanent presence on the moon. And one of the differences on this mission from the Apollo missions,
yes,
is that we're going to be able to go to the South Pole. And that's really important, because if we can find water, that's going to enable people to stay.
The South Pole of the moon?
Yes. The Apollo missions were only able to go to the equator because the poles take a lot more energy. You have to have a more powerful rocket. And so we've got this super powerful rocket, the Artemis I.
To learn more about Aerojet Rocketdyne and the Artemis program, take a look at the Rocket.com website. In Canoga Park, Gayle Anderson, KTLA 5 News.